kidding. Allow yourself to videotape yourself in the mirror. I always wanted to do this. Allow. Hey. Allowing was the theme that I created for this month. And the allowing to me is a state. It's a way of experiencing your inside world, which dictates how you experience your outside world. So allowing is this flow of energy. Allowing is not resistance. Allowing, there's a relief in the experience of allowing, and there's a tightness in the feeling of resistance. So the blog on Saturday talked about a story about a little girl and her experience of a moment. So there was all of these dynamics going on. There was an unexpected snowstorm. It was cold. There was an unexpected request for all staff to be outside. Since the snowstorm was relatively unexpected, most people, and it was only like high 30s, so most people didn't have super warm clothes. And there was a ton of cars. It was, you know, after school time between 3:30, 4:15. So the story that most people were probably telling maybe had to do with some sense of rush or discomfort. And this little girl was in the moment of her life, and it started to snow, and she captured this essence of living and being alive by just stating, "It's snowing." And it's not that the snow was responsible for that feeling. One, it's little girl. They're closer to their nature if we would be observers of the children around us. And two, she was experiencing the moment. And so there was an essence in this moment. There was this expansive aliveness that to me was a sense of possibility. So allowing for a sense of possibility. So that's my first skill, is learning how to notice those moments in our life where we allow it, where we allow it to just be what it is, and when we allow it, we have an opportunity to appreciate it. And that's, if you've ever heard me talk about the gush, allowing a moment that's expansive and feels good, and then appreciating it, allows it to grow, allows it to get bigger. And I've called that the gush, which I call this experience of love, this expansive, open, flowing experience of being alive and attuned to what is. So that's the first skill. The second skill is we start to tell a story about we have this experience, and then we might tell a story about it. And when we can learn to tell a story that is life-giving, that's when we start to grow these sustainable outcomes. That's where discomfort leads to growth, and it leads to an evolving of our humanness, versus always feeling stuck or spinning in the same space. So if we start to tell this story about that good feeling, like, it's cold out, it's time for dinner, aren't you hungry? Did you have a good day? Where's your stuff? So referencing that little girl, like, she has this essence of humanness, like, it's snowing, and just capturing that moment, and then that fast, hurried pace. Did you forget something? You know, or we got to get here, or whatever life happens. We can learn how to notice the story retelling where like, yeah, great, it's snowing, but there's a lot of other stuff going on too. You know, there's climate change and why do you think it's snowing in September or whatever else it could be. And learning how to flip these stories we tell, like what if it actually is okay to be happy? What if it actually is okay to feel expansive? What if we're meant to feel the essence of new beginning? And then the last skill is something that I actually just started doing with kids, and naming the experience and naming it using color, texture, purpose, and size. Okay, so skill number one is based off the story of the little girl and the first snowstorm. You can read my blog on sallyseifferco.blog. Allow, the story is the first, is the introduction in the blog. So here's the skill, is in your day-to-day life, right now, seeing if you can bring your awareness to the moments that we have that are just like that little girl. My guess is that they happen quite often and we just don't always capture them. And one of the reasons that I think that we don't capture them is that it's natural to have the experience of being alive. It's natural to be connected and feel this source of life-giving instead of this depletion. So when we feel the depletion, we notice it because it's not natural. So it gets our attention, and whatever gets our attention gets our focus, and that's where we can create change, and not just create change in the moment, but create a sustainable change that's constantly building on itself. And sometimes when you're in these change moments, there's still these like natural laws in the universe. So there's this ebb and flow. So sometimes it feels like you're going back in order to go forward. So here's the skill, is when you notice this expansive feeling of a moment. So, and you could probably put it on the word love. So it could be your pet, it could be in nature, you could just capture a tree that you've never noticed before, or the squirrels playing, or birds, or the sky, or you're just observing children and just noticing the intricacies of their like shape of their nose or their ears or their hand, and you're allowing that experience to be what it is. And when you can notice it and allow it and just have it, you are, in essence, you're appreciating it, and what you appreciate grows. And just like how when you're in social media and you Google certain things and then all those advertisements start to show up, or things start to match whatever it is you're demonstrating an interest in, that's life. That's so when you start to appreciate this goodness, you start to be attracted to more of it. And it's not like it wasn't there before. It was just where your focus was. So that's the first skill. Notice, allow, appreciate, and just have the experience. So flip it is a skill that I've taught before, and I use it a lot. And when you practice it, it becomes very natural. You start to notice, so you have this good feeling or you're having this experience, and you notice this disruptive thought, this blurt that kind of wants to say, yeah, that's actually not true. You know, that's not the way this is going. You know, life is cruel, life is bad, things aren't meant to work out. And if you can catch those blurts early enough, you can flip them so fast. and just shift the energy. And what happens the more you practice and the more space you create, you see the end game. And what you see is that even though you can validate this thought, like, well, it's really not that great right now, even if you can validate that and have plenty of evidence to prove it, where do you go from there? Like, you can't go anywhere from there. And once you start to recognize that the path that this thought is going to take you on, you can flip your thinking, like, well, what if things are okay? What if it's not true, meaning that the negative piece isn't true? You know, what if it could be different? And just by having that thought shift, your energy shifts, and you just get back into this expansive, integrated space, balance, equilibrium, homeostasis. So learning how to catch those thoughts and flip those thoughts is a huge skill. And basically, it's what's happening the other way, right? Like, ah, life is so good, right? And then we flip that, like, oh no, if we think that, things will happen. So it's just, we're flipping all that. Okay, so this last skill, and sorry it's so small, I just don't feel like writing it over again. So this is fun. This is something I'm doing in real time, and I've been doing it this school year, and I'm going to do it this morning with a group, like a class group of kindergartners, and it's going to be fun. So it's this skill of noticing the experience of your inside world and naming it, and then specifically coming up with language that represents color, texture, purpose, the job, and size. So kids, but also adults, we're taking in all this energy and information through our senses, and then we have to organize it. And a lot of times we can't keep up. We can't organize it quick enough. And so, like, the light, it's too much, or the touch, the discomfort of clothing. You know, we can't organize it fast enough and make a request for maybe something softer, or be able to articulate the discomfort. We just react to it, you know, too much or tight. So for kids, it's helps them attune to their experience of just being alive in the world when you bring their awareness to the sensory experience of their life. So, but it's good for everyone. So in the blog, I talked about the Sedona method that really made a difference for me. It was learning how to actually be with what was happening inside. So a feeling comes up and you notice it. And then once you notice it, you can make a choice about it. Like, can I allow this feeling to just be what it is? And am I open to letting it go? And then the last question is, when can I let it go? So, and those aren't the exact, you can Google the Sedona method. It's been a long time since I've practice it, but not, because it becomes a natural habit. Like, you allow your experience, and when you allow it, you know it's moving. You just start to tune into energy, and you recognize that, ooh, there's that. And when you allow it, you're not resisting it, and you're not telling a story about it. You're letting it release, just like weather. Like, it's constantly, energy is dynamic. It's constantly changing. So this skill, notice and then name. So color could be bright, dull, fluorescent. I feel light. So it's not, and some kids might be a certain particular color, and they might actually notice these colors, like these energy waves or whatever inside of them. They might actually notice in their mind space, their heart space, their belly space, their skin, their muscles, noticing. So color and then texture can be fun. If you Google different textures, like slimy, you know, my skin feels slimy, I don't like it. Or smooth, obviously, rough, hard, soft, bumpy, rigid. So I don't have it in front of me, but if you Google different textures, there's some fun ones as far as learning how to name the experience inside. And you don't have to break it down into, like if you're teaching this to older kids, you can start to teach the mind space, heart space, belly space, skin and muscles. But like this morning, we're just gonna name our feeling using, we're probably just gonna do a texture to just share and name how we're feeling. So I feel slimy, and it'll probably get kind of silly, but it's bringing their awareness to their inside world and the texture of life, like being fully alive, being fully integrated into day, into moment. And so purpose is, what job does it have? And that's a curious question. Like, what job does my anger have? What job does this this thick feeling, this dark feeling, what job does it have? What's its job? And then size, is it big? Is it small? Is it growing? Is it shrinking? So just different ways to be curious, different ways to draw awareness, different ways to express. And when you start to be curious about this inside world and notice and put a name on it, you're the noticer, you're the namer, you're the observer, you're not that big feeling. Have a great week. This is the end. You're a shining star, no matter who you are, shining bright to see, what you can truly be, what you can truly be. Just a check.